Hello everyone and welcome back to Olympuscraft SMP. Today is going to be a scary episode, so we gotta gear up because we're going on a Nether expedition today. We've been exploring the overworld, and today I want to explore that new Nether that we discovered last episode when we lit the portal in front of our giant pumpkin. But there's something that needs to be done first. Ender Yeti apparently wants to make some sort of a deal. He's yelling at me. So, let's inquire about this. I haven't really done anything since the last episode. All of the stuff in the storage is the same. No additions to the pumpkin. I've been working on my mini castle in Junicraft. So, yeah, we might want to sleep as well. Yes. I am, don't worry. Steer Cat slept the night away for us. So, yeah, the only thing that I did do on Olympuscraft since the last episode is get more waypoints or waystones, I guess. So, we had the pumpkin in spawn last time. Oh.
Lag. Lag.
Hi.
Ah, hi.
Being invaded.
Okay. So, I want to make a business proposition with you.
Okay, what might this be?
You have something that I need.
Oh. I barely have anything, so.
You are living very close to a witch hat.
Oh, I see. I hope you're not looking for the witch.
I'm looking to make a farm there.
A farm in the witch hut?
Yes.
How
Because
does
you can
that
make a
work?
witch farm, and then I wanted to make a redstone shop.
Okay.
I was prepared to give you a half price discount permanently at the shop if you allow me to build it near you.
Yeah, go ahead. I wasn't gonna use the hut for anything.
That is amazing. I didn't want to build a farm really close to you. Otherwise. And I come with gift for people that agree to my terms. Have a hunger ring.
I have a second one now.
Oh, see, I was prepared for this. So instead, have a diamond block.
Ooh, I like the diamond block.
I figured. But I'm gonna have to make a whole bunch of redstone things, so I thought I would need a nice farm.
Well, yeah, feel free to use it. There is
You may have
there's a cat
sticks
around here
too.
that
Oh,
I
there is
want
a
to get.
cat.
Yeah, I want to get the cat at some point. I don't know where it is, but it's out there.
Well,
All right.
thank you for agreeing to my terms and conditions, and I promise there is no fine print.
All right. So, yeah, I get a half price discount off at the redstone shop that's being built, and there he goes, flying away. I don't know if that's where spawn is. I should probably actually make a legitimate waypoint just for the direction. So, I could do that right here. We could do spawn, and spawn can be, I don't know, blue. That's what it is on Junicraft. So there we go. There's our spawn waypoint. Oh, and Ender Yeti's already here as well. All right, let's go back to the pumpkin. And yeah, so I'm pretty sure I have a fishing rod. I could go fishing for a little bit. So there's a couple things I'm gonna do. I'm gonna go fishing. I'm gonna find the cat first so that I can kind of be around it. And fish up a couple of stuff and tame said kitty. We're gonna get Eerie today and then we're gonna go into the Nether. This just in, modded fish. We got an anchovy and a few other things, but I think after this next fish, I should be able to go get Eerie. Oh, okay, that's a shrimp. We can catch those too. They're already, I don't know, deshelled. Or whatever you do with shrimp. But, I don't know. Four fish, it might be enough. I know that I saw Eerie this way somewhere, so get the stuff out. Actually, I should probably do this. Eerie should be somewhere over here. I'm not used to playing without swift sneak anymore, which I should probably get used to again for all of the things that we are about to do. Oh, hello. I can't get you through the grass. Oh, it only took one. Sweet. Okay. Well, we have Eerie now. We have ourselves a kitty cat. So let's go back to the pumpkin and get some orange dye for that collar. Oh, there we go. Oh, and she's just running straight up the stairs, making herself comfortable. All right, let's put, I don't even think we can fit any of this anywhere. So, diamonds, we got 24 now. Got some fish as well. Anchovy, interestingly enough. All right, I don't think we're ever going to need twigs. I say that, and we'll probably end up needing them at some point. But where are those flowers? There's one. Got the orange dye for the collar, and now we can make Eerie the official kitty. And I still haven't put any decorations on this thing. Perhaps I should get clay at some point, too, and we can take a couple more of these orange daisies and just decorate the bedroom. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There we go. So, there's 1, 2. Put a daisy there, and reload the shaders. I need to change the key for that. Check this out. Very, very nice. Very comfy, cozy. Now it looks like home. So, that's over with. So we can take the bricks, put them, I guess, up there. And now we can go to the Nether. We're going to leave everybody here because otherwise they're just going to get lost or worse. So let's go. See you guys in hell. And here we are. So we saw a little bit of this place before. This is the Erisian undergrowth, I think. The one with the withering oak log, which I might chop down a tree or two just to see the wood that it gives. I'm very curious if it's going to be like a black wood or something. Oh no, it just gives you oak. Okay, well if that's the case, we're not going to turn those into planks or anything. I was hoping that it would give us like black planks, because that's another thing that we don't really have in vanilla. Black planks would make for a very nice spooky build, but perhaps another tree. We could try to chop down this one, see what it gives. Oh, it's got magma blocks in it too. And this looks like honey, but it is something else, gel. Which, does it drop? It drops something, I think. Ember gel ball. Interesting. And we got some branches. So what does this give us? Oh, here's a blackish plank. So yeah, see, this looks more like the withering oak. I was thinking that this might give us something yellowish or orange, but this will be nice to have, so I'll take a few of these pedu. Don't know what that is, but I like the way that the, ooh, I like the way that those look. So we'll take a few things home. That'll be nice. I don't know what you do with all this gel. I do know what you do with these guys. Cuberts! Oh, so where do we want to go? Wherever shows us a good place. We don't have a saddle or anything to get a strider. Magmatic stone? Interesting. Yeah, and also I don't know exactly what's been discovered. And lava, very scary. At least gravestones are a thing. I take comfort in that. But I feel like avoiding the magma cube biome would probably be smarter, but since when have I done the smart thing? Alright, so I don't know. Does this area over here? I did see like a nether fortress or something, I think, to the west, but I also saw mining paths. It was all on my mini-map, so I assume that whatever's been going on there has already been discovered. So I'm not really looking for anything specific, more so what we've been doing, just being a nomad. We're another nomad this time. And I'm just gonna see if I can find some biomes, some modded materials, maybe a structure and some treasure if we happen to come across one, but, you know, we're appreciating the scenery today, because look at this, and there is a blaze up there. Is he shooting at me? Oh, man. That is terrifying. You know what? I might build straight up. I wish that I had that fire resistance ring code had. That would be such a useful tool right now. But, oh my goodness. Alright. Hopefully I don't get knocked off here. Alright. Ooh. Here's a guy. We do have a bow, and it's infinity, so we don't have to worry about running out of arrows. Unfortunately, this is no eldritch bow, so it will break eventually. But, yeah, I guess we could just go this way. Further into the Ember Bog. Ember with a U, for some reason. And there goes our deep slate. So, I guess we're switching to the planks. We have blue netherrack now, which is interesting. This is so foolish. You know what I should have done? I should have made a waypoint for my portal. Oh well. At least I have coordinates on my screen at all times. I assume that this wood doesn't burn, so it should be safe to use. I also missed my frostwalker. Oh my gosh. I want to get out of this biome. I don't like this. I'm surprised that I haven't, like, taken fire damage yet. Watch me burn to death in, like, 5 minutes. Okay. This seems like something different over here. So, let's hop over. Weeping Mire. Ooh, nice and purple. There's, like, lava lily pads down there, too. This is very, very interesting. Okay, so, we can get more wood from this purple tree. So that's good. Is there, like, any structure anywhere? There's a quartz desert that way. There doesn't seem to really be much of anything this way. What is this? Brimstone Caverns? Don't know what that is. I don't see any fortresses or bastions or anything. But we do have some new biomes. So maybe we'll try to make our way over to those. It's not so easy in the Nether. All right. This should be good for now. We got 40 bluish planks. I don't think there's a blue. Well, warped is blue, but it's a different kind of blue. It's a bit brighter. I hear our foes somewhere over here. Oh. Hey, bud. Oh, I forgot how much damage mobs do on this server. They do so much. Heal me, backpack. I'm so grateful that we have the, I don't want to say nice one, but you're nicer than the one that just attacked me. Alright. Last of those, so we'll switch to the blue planks now, and I guess go back from whence we came. I was just set on fire by blazes, and I almost just fell in lava right there. Alright. Alrighty. Let's see if we can. Ooh, I hit him from below. Into fire, I'll say. Well, I did take some fire damage right there. Oh man, the blazes. He's gonna fire at me. He is not a good shot at all. Okay. Well, we have a blaze rod. Alright, now he's shooting. Alright, I don't think we're gonna be able to hit that guy from here. The blazes spawned in the trees, apparently. Alright, so we're just going into all the fire today. Oh! What? Where was that fireball? Oh no! How does magma cream burn? Can anyone tell me how that logic works. There's a blaze over this way. Come on, let's go, let's do this. Oh. I feel like the piglin is a bigger threat than the blaze right now. Oh. Okay, we got that guy. We get another blaze rod? We did. We got a second one. All right. So, yeah. I wonder if there's a biome that spawns nether wart as a little plant like this. It's just on the ground. I remember in the last Hearts of Gold UHC, there was a type of cave that spawned nether wart, because it was cave biome data pack that we were using. That was the little twist on it. And I remember that my team got potions without actually having to go to the nether, because we found blaze spawners in a dungeon, and I think there was a nether wart farm in there. Oh, go away. But yeah, that's probably the only time potions have ever been gotten in a UHC without someone having gone to the nether. Because I don't know if the winning team that also had potions had gone to the nether in that season, but there's a very good chance that they didn't. You know, I can think of one good reason that I would need redstone, because I'm not a redstone guy, but making potions is definitely a thing that I do. And since redstone's also the one that extends it, I'm getting hit from multiple directions right now. Fire away! And you're dead. Alright. But yeah, I have blaze rods and magma cream, so if I just had nether wart and, you know, glass, I could make some fire resistance potions. But yeah, the nether wart's kinda the tricky part, because by the time you got that, you've already been in here. But we're back where we started. What was that? That scared me so bad. We're back at the starting point now. But I don't even know what's going on in chat right now. Choose either 4 or 5. I like 5. So I'll choose 5, although everyone's choosing 5. So oh, look at this. Wait, is this my portal? No, it's not. Whose is this? I think I might have been elsewhere. Okay, I'm gonna see where this goes. Oh, I'm in somebody's factory. Looks like it's Jay Blader's. Okay, so I guess I found his portal. See this? This is the kind of stuff I don't understand. Gears in Minecraft. Yeah, I'm just gonna go back to where I came from. I think this is the Quartz Desert or something, so we could check this out. We're treading into previously explored territory, but yeah, this is quartz sand. I think there was like a crystal. Yeah, it's just a straight up quartz crystal right there. Oh, I see a thing over there. There's a bridge that somebody built. I'm probably gonna get lost in here, honestly, but it'll all be worth it for the scenery, because this is something that looks very alien, and you, sir, are gonna have to make some room on this thing. Alright, so this is the Glowstone Gardens. Ooh. So what is this, Soul Shroom Block? Oh man, this is the type of alien landscape that I'm kind of looking for to take inspiration from for my stories, because the human realm of things... Oh. Nether bristle, interesting. The human realm of things in the Son of Darkness story, if you didn't know, it's a tidally locked planet. There's a daytime side where all the humans live, and a nighttime side where all of the nations live, like me. And so yeah, that's what my skin is, if anyone is new here and was wondering what the story behind my demon face is. So yeah, it's pretty straightforward with the human side of things. It doesn't look like... Oh, this dropped something. Yeah, you know, the daytime side, it's got your pretty typical deserts, plains, jungles, forests, you know, the stuff we're used to. The overworld. But I want to take inspiration from, like, nether and maybe end biomes for the dark side, because it's a lot of strange stuff going on there. You know, everyone expects it to just be a frozen wasteland that the sun never shines on. No life, no nothing. But that's not the case, is it? No, there's shadow people that live there. And there's a whole thing. And the main place, Darkrim, in the Minecraft stuff that I've done surrounding, I guess, the prototype lore for it, which is like the Unknown Empire SMP and stuff like that. The Crimson Forest, with all the Crimson Fungi and stuff. And Umbara from the Clone Wars, that's kind of where I've been taking inspiration from for that area. But it's not the only part. Obviously, there's going to be different types of places. So, yeah. Oh, I guess soul shrooms just keep dropping from... Oh, that's an interesting thing. Yeah, I guess that's what drops from these. But, yeah, there's going to be a whole bunch of different places. And, you know, stuff like this is really what I'm looking for. Stuff that just looks completely alien. That you've never seen. And that's why I like to play around with biome mods like this. And... one of the main reasons that I really want to dedicate Olympuscraft to exploring. And there's a fortress up there. I wonder if anyone's been there. I assume so. Although, yeah, I don't know. I assume so. It looks like someone was mining netherite over that way. Which is something we could do, but I don't really want to. At least not right now. I'm pretty sure I said that in Junicraft, and then I ended up making several sets of netherite armor, but... I didn't have another SMP going on at that time, so yeah, Olympuscraft, it's going to be, hopefully, a very chill experience. So yeah, there's more mushrooms and stuff up there, some gold over this way, mycelium netherrack, that is interesting, I guess that fits in this biome, so, oh yeah, someone was definitely here. Well, I don't know, I doubt that they left anything behind, but... It's still a thing to explore, I guess. Yeah. To find completely unexplored stuff at this point, we'd probably have to go very far away. And the easiest way to do that, of course, would just be to build a portal in the overworld that's very, very far from spawn, which I think we kind of looped back around and made the pumpkin pretty close to spawn. So, obviously, we're going to pop out in places that people have already been to. But we're in a Crimson Gardens biome now, so maybe we'll see what's up with that. It looks like Blackstone... Oh, this is Darkroom right here. Blackstone and the Crimson Fungi stuff. Yeah, is there an indoor portion? I feel like that's where we just were. Oh, there's a skeleton over there. A wither skeleton. We meet again at last! Oh, there's two of them. Come on, boyos. Oh, he just fell. Ooh, he withered me. Would you... You know what? Oh, I'm almost dead. They hit hard. They certainly hit hard. How long did he wither me for? Oh, it's almost over. Okay, so I almost died from that one guy. And if I die in here, I'm not confident that we'll be able to... recover things, so... Yeah, I don't have any food or anything on me, really. So we're just gonna have to wait for the regen. At least the hunger doesn't go down. Okay, this guy... Come on, climb back up. Where is he? There he is. He's elusive. This is the real skeleton right here. Alright, there we go. He dropped, I think, coal. But yeah, this is, I guess, like... Warped and Crimson... Forests... Like, upgraded a bunch? Let's get you. There we go. Taking down all the wither skeletons of this place. So yeah, there's a lot more glowing going on here with the, shroom lights. Yeah. I couldn't remember what they were called. Lots more vines, too. I wonder if the vanilla ones are still around. They're probably significantly rarer, considering how much they've added. Oh! Oh yeah, we don't want to be fighting these guys. I see hoglins, too. Hoglins, we definitely don't want to be fighting, because they will just eat us alive. Those already do so much damage, even when you're not on hard difficulty and lagging up a storm. See, I lag on Junicraft too, but it seems to be worse on Olympuscraft for whatever reason. I'm sorry, little Cuberts, but I need your essence. I need your creams. Just collect some mushrooms as well. Get all these fools out of here. Magma Cubes are probably my favorite mob in this game. They're just adorable. and just the right amount of deadly. And they give you fire resistance material, so, you know, they're very, very useful. Oh, what happened here? I feel like I'm investigating the aftermath of a great battle. Because I know that when the season first started, they, like, right away went on a big Nether expedition. So this is probably, ooh, the aftermath of that. So everything is just in ruins. Fortresses were already kind of destroyed before, but whatever happened, there was some great Nether battle. Oh! Oh my goodness. It's following in the lore of the dying world of Minecraftia. Minecraft does have a kind of post-apocalyptic vibe with all of the zombies. There's like no inhabitants other than very scattered rural settlements and villages. And all these structures like bastions, nether fortresses, strongholds, they're all abandoned and in ruins. So it certainly fits the theme coming in here after everybody's kind of ransacked the place. Oh. There we go. Hey, buddy. You can't get me, can you? Alright, did we get all the skeletons? There's a couple over there somewhere. We're just going on a killing spree of all the skull remnants. Oh my goodness. Go away! Yeah, that's the thing. I should not be getting hit by these guys half the time, and yet they still find a way to do it. And the Wither is very unforgiving, but I think we've seen enough of this place. There's probably not anything I'm gonna get out of it besides just some fun battles with some angry skeletons, so let's go. I think it is time to make our escape. The Nether isn't really the best place to explore, it seems. We're either surrounded by netherrack or giant oceans of lava that are not gonna be good to cross, so I'm going to try to find that portal to Jayblader's base and see if he's got a waystone. At the very least, being in the overworld will be better than being out here in the Nether. Oh, I think I see an escape route. Gonna have to make our way over there, but there's somebody's tunnel, so screw it, we're just jumping. Be jumping everywhere. Okay, so this Nether hub is a complete mystery to me. I don't know what's in it, who connects to it, but maybe we can find some bases that we haven't seen yet, like Steercats. I don't know where she is or what she's doing on this server, but there's a portal, so we're free. All right, we're in somebody's house, so. Oh my goodness, look at this storage room. This is crazy. There's like little locks on it. Quad drawer. I think I remember seeing a drawers mod. Oh wait, I think I was here. I don't remember whose place this is. There's a lot of rings. I think this might be, is it Ender Yeti's place? Man, I have no idea. But their waystone. Yeah, this is Ender Yeti. Okay, so I was right. I don't think I showed his place on camera, but it looks fantastic, just like all the others. And yeah, you can see his collection of rings on all the pedestals, and he's pretty close to spawn. So yeah, his place was pretty easy to find. All right, well, that's good. So we got that taken care of. So let's go back to the pumpkin. I think we're done with the exploration for today. There's the portal. You know what? Oh my goodness. In the event that I ever do decide to go back, I should probably make a waypoint in there. Oh boy, and we're already in trouble again. Okay, we got you. Got any rods for us, my friend, since you were so eager to start a fight? Oh, he did. Okay. And we have this fine gentleman over here as well. Ooh, we don't want to sprint towards him. Come on. Our bow has definitely taken a beating with this little expedition. But yeah, that's what happens when you can't really do sword combat, because you're gonna just die. Oh, man. I don't even... At least there's water on the other side of this, but this is what I get for going back into the Nether. I hope that it's not just gonna, like, take away all my hearts. Okay. Well, there's water. Alright, so let's try that again, and this time actually make the waypoint. Alright, everybody, there we go. We have made our waypoint for the portal, so now we can get out of here for good. And, yeah, I don't know if we're ever coming back. Yeah, I think I've had enough of the Nether for a little while. We saw a few biomes, not as much as I was hoping for, but yeah, it's very difficult to explore that. And I don't even think we have... Well, I don't know if Oh the Biomes You'll Go extends to the end. I know that they had to remove Better End for reasons that I don't remember, but yeah, I don't know if I ever want to explore the end, honestly. I'm content with where I am, so I'm probably just going to throw all of this in the upper chest, and I guess we can just take all of the twigs and whatever. Alright, so top row for valuables, more or less. Glowstone we can put up there, and we'll just stick all the rest of this stuff in here. I'm sure that we have plenty of those. Oh, we don't have any more bones? What happened to all of them? Well, we can definitely do this. So, there we go. Everybody's still safe and sound in here. Eerie's still sitting with the cozy flowers. I love the look of this place. It's, it's quite humble, but it is still home. That is going to be it for this episode, though, so I hope that you all enjoyed the Nether exploration and the little trade deal that we made with Ender Yeti. So apparently we're going to have some kind of a farm right next to us very soon, which should be interesting. I don't know how that's going to go, but I guess we'll find out when he builds it. But until then, I'm going to go back into my humble little pumpkin and see you all another day. Goodbye, everyone.